morning. My name is Janelle Breeze Biagione. I'm the wife and widow of Constable Gerald Breeze, regimental number 30967. My husband died in the line of duty as the result of a police motorcycle crash in Penticton, BC in 1990. It was a great honor last night for my husband, my daughters, my grandsons, and myself to be a part of Constable Sarah Beckett's Candlelight Walk in Langford. I was also honored to bring remarks, and this video is a recap of the expression of sorrow and condolences that I brought forward to the public and that I would like to share with the community at large. On behalf of my family and the Constable Gerald Breeze Center for Traumatic Life Losses, I offer my sincere condolences to Constable Sarah Beckett's family and fellow officers, in particular to Constable Beckett's family. We share in your heartbreak of losing a loved one in the line of duty. While we know that the public's outpouring of respect and public expression of sorrow will be a source of peace and comfort to you, we also know that the days and even years ahead will be the most difficult to go on without her. We pray for your strength and for your courage. To Constable Beckett's husband, I am truly sorry for your loss. I too was left with two small children. I share in the heartbreak of losing your spouse, your love, your confidant, and the co-creator of your beautiful children. There will not be a day that you won't think of your wife and her beautiful spirit. Every day you will see her essence flow brightly through your children in every breath and step they take. May the love you shared as a family carry you through this difficult journey from loss to healing. To Constable Beckett's children, we send you our heartfelt love and adoration. May you feel your beautiful mother's spirit hovering close by each and every day. For all who knew the Sarah behind the title Constable Beckett, you are now charged with the honor and responsibility to carry her essence and the love she had in with her children in your hearts to share with them whenever and wherever you can. Her children will come to treasure these moments of storytelling and sharing of memories, for this is how they will get to know their mother and to feel close to her again. To Constable Beckett's fellow officers, we are sorry that you have lost a beloved friend and colleague. We send you prayers of strength and courage as the days ahead will be trying and difficult for you to get through. The reality is that you do not have the opportunity to spend life and to grieve your loss. Your work demands that you do, will, and must continue to protect and serve our community with precision and professionalism in the way you have been trained. For this, we thank you and we commend you for your bravery. I do want to encourage you to know that grief does not stand down on a time frame. It will not pay heed to the time that your shift begins or your shift ends. It will be there. It is okay and wonderful if you're able to put it aside to do the work that you need to do. But I encourage each and every one of you to take moments, to take time to heal for you, for your family, and for Constable Beckett. To Ryan Carvath, I am so grateful and applaud you for organizing this event. Your simple effort to extend an invitation on Facebook for residents of Langford to come together and remember Constable Beckett has brought powerful healing to our community. Never underestimate the tremendous effect a seemingly small gesture can have. Thank you. And finally, to Constable Beckett, thank you for your service. You will never be forgotten. To the unknown cadet at Depot who will receive Constable Beckett's card with her picture and story, please know that your silent partner is a very special angel sitting on your shoulder. Sarah, may you fly with the angels and God keep you close each and every day.